We are now quickly demonstrating some of the applications that we have developed. What you see here is a robo. Some of you would have seen a similar robo in our earlier demonstration. This robo itself is an educational robo developed in our embedded real-time systems lab by Professor Kaviarya and his team. This is traditionally controlled from PCs on Wi-Fi. Last year, some students developed a control using Android. This year, in the last 3 months, during the months of summer, a team of 6 students, not IIT students, but summer interns from various colleges like VNIT Nagpur, Pune, COIP Pune, I think somebody was there from Mesra, Rachi, whatever, some 6 students, they developed a complete control application on Aakash. You can see that robo is moving actually. It is not just the control of the robo, but you can see that there is a camera mounted on the robo. And can you show the, take it back and show the people. Now you see the Aakash tablet, the video, or point it to those people there. Point it somewhere where the, see, there is a camera on top of robo. The camera is capturing live video. Now that is also coming to the Aakash tablet. So if you see, this is the Aakash tablet. This Aakash tablet is showing the video from this robo. Yes, you can move your hand and it will check it. It's correct. Yeah, okay, somebody in that corner, can you raise your hand? Then we'll see whether it is working or not. Yes. Now, this might look like a childish demo, but it's a demo of an engineering control. I actually demonstrated it by controlling the robo in our lab from New York and Canada. So it is not necessary that you control it from here. It has a Raspberry Pi board. Rajesh's team has put the entire Linux kernel on top of it. It controls the robo as well as the Wi-Fi camera, connects it on Wi-Fi access point, which connects to Aakash tablet. And the robo control application is actually loaded onto the Aakash tablet. So that will be one of the applications which we'll be releasing in open source. And those of you who are interested in such robo control can take that base application and do whatever you want, because the entire source code will be available in open source. Now, additionally, we have applications such as proximity, which permits creation of interactive lessons. Parag Tiwari's team has been working on it for the last 3 years. Originally, these lessons were supposed to be used on desktop. Now these lessons can be seen and listened to from the Aakash tablet itself. We have spoken tutorials. Many of you would have participated in the spoken tutorials. All the spoken tutorials and several other educational contents can now be seen on Aakash. Most importantly, to emphasize the full form of LCAD, as I mentioned, it is low-cost access cum computing device. Now, ordinarily, tablets are only access devices. Have you ever seen an iPad or any other Android tablet available in the market in which you can write C, C++ programs? Generally, that programming is limited to desktops. Our team has actually implemented a Linux layer on top of Android, and they have ported C, C++, Python, and Scilab. All of it works on the Aakash tablet now. So that means if you are using the tablets to teach a first year course in C, C++, the students can actually write programs, save programs, run programs, compile programs on the Aakash tablet itself. We believe it has been a substantial contribution. All of it will go in open source anyway. Now, the key thing is none of this software is preloaded on the tablets. When the tablets start getting manufactured in the Indian manufacturer of DataVent, which will start happening somewhere around middle or towards the end of this month, the subsequent tablets will preload all the software there. Currently, the only software that comes preloaded is the standard Android operating system and the Android related applications which are there. What it means is that when you get the tablets, you will have to load all the software on those tablets. Now, for loading the software, that is for installing the software on Android, there is a process. I believe that process has been documented and it is uploaded on the Moodle. Effectively, what you do while installing software is, there is a package called APK. They are called APK files. So you download those APK files on Android, and once they are put there, you just touch on them, they will get installed. The entire installation process has been indicated on the Moodle. That is what you will have to try. The Aakash tablets that you see in your hands does not have a regular USB port. It has a mini USB port. So you need a small cable. In your packet, there will be a small cable which is an extender, which will take the mini USB and will give you a regular USB thing. To that USB, you can put either a USB pen drive, or you can connect it to your laptop or wherever it is, and do the necessary installation. That procedure is already given. But what it means is, you will have to install this software in the tablets that you receive. Now, assuming that some of you receive these tablets only on 8th night or 9th morning, you will have to do something on war footing to install this software on those 20 or 40 tablets that you get. Each tablet takes about 1.5 minutes to install. The way we do it is, we put 10 people around, and each of them takes a tablet, connects it to a laptop or connects it to a USB dongle and install it. So what you could do is, after going back, you may want to create multiple USB dongles at your own place, 10 or 15, and keep them ready by downloading all the APK files on them, so that you don't require PCs, etc. Or you could keep 8 or 10 PCs. One resource that I would like to suggest to you, which we use heavily in such emergencies, is our third year or fourth year students. You will find that in your college also, there will be 8 or 10 students who will know much more than all of us combined on how to install software on Android and so on. You tell them these instructions, put them in a row, and in about 1 hour, they will install all the software on all your things. The software is identical, so you need to test only on one or two. There are manuals there which will tell you how to use those applications. But this time, because we did not have enough time to discuss this, you will have to discover these things on your own. In case of any problem, we will have only Moodle things. We will put an FAQ and we will constantly upgrade that FAQ. Anybody feels a problem should set it up on the discussion forum that we will create. And anybody who finds a solution should post a solution on that discussion forum. That is the way the collaboration works. In short then, there are 4 or 5 applications, including spoken tutorials. In fact, let me just introduce the teams at least, because we don't have time to go through all those applications. So Rajesh, will you please stand up? They have already seen you. He is the person, his team has done both the clicker and the robo application. Parag Tiwari is not here, but is there somebody from his team? They have developed the proximity application, and they also wrote the initial scripts for installation of applications and so on. There is a small team which comprises of animators. There are, by the way, educational animations. They come from our Oscar project. Since the result of those animations are directly AVI files, they can be played using any media player. And Aakash Tablet has the normal media player, Adobe Reader, etc., etc. Spoken tutorial is another very exciting initiative which creates 10 minutes tutorials on specific topics. In fact, somebody suggested that they would be creating open spoken tutorials on Android development, a series of them. And we believe, I will indicate it later during a talk in the main workshop, how 10-minute, 15-minute duration videos or 10-minute, 15-minute duration lectures are going to be the cornerstone of the emerging educational methodology. These one-hour lectures are going to be passe. We have to forget them as soon as possible. But that's a different story. We have Shama here. Shama, can you please stand up? She heads the spoken tutorial team. This is Professor Kannan Mouthgalya's initiative. You will see Kannan on 10th or 11th. Later, some of you would have seen him earlier. And he is essentially the driving force behind this. Kannan is also a driving force behind another important attempt, that is the C, C++ programming environment. Let me tell you, all other applications that we have, we spoke of, including the RoboControl, work has been going on in IIT over the last 2 or 3 years on variety of development. I merely coordinated by exciting them to contribute to this. But the C, C++ environment was started from scratch in the month of May. And by August, they had completed the development. It's one of the greatest hack. They did it first for the Android 2.2, and of course it works on Android 4 now. So Srikant, Patnaik and Sachin, both of them are not here. As we speak, they are busy in further hacking. What they are doing is, they are trying to make this tablet a dual boot tablet from the SD card so that the second boot is Linux itself. So it is no more an Android tablet, it's a Linux machine. And by the way, this is not hypothetical. 3 days ago, around midnight, I actually saw the first Ubuntu Linux working on Aakash. So it works. If you realize that this 2,263 rupees device is actually far more powerful than the PC-80 that we had one time, then you can see that there is no problem there. Of course, there is no SD card, by the way, in your Aakash tablets. The SD card cost is not covered by the funding that we have received. What we are presuming is that people who use these tablets, both teachers and students, would put the SD card of their choice. Currently, it has 4 GB of internal flash, out of which 2 GB is used for system software, and the other 2 GB is partitioned as an internal SD card. So from that internal SD card, that is where these applications will be downloaded, contents could be downloaded. You can use that without using an SD card. So all the software and contents that you get on the Moodle are installable without any SD card. However, the students and teachers are free to use SD cards of their choice. Incidentally, the slot supports SD cards of up to 32 GB. So people can even watch full-length movies, although that is not advisable. The last thing I would like to tell you about the configuration is, I already told you it is a 1 GHz processor, 512 MB RAM, Android 4, and capacitive touchscreen. Additionally, you have known about the SD card slot. There is a Wi-Fi connectivity, but it is not a phone, so there is no SIM card slot. But Wi-Fi connectivity is there, and if you are connected using Wi-Fi to internet, you can browse internet. We have successfully loaded Skype on Aakash. It works because it has a front camera. I will end by telling you the story about that camera. When we negotiated, the upgrade of the technical specifications were limited to what was there originally. So better processor, more memory, etc., etc. But there was no camera. We got the first devices running Android 2.2, 3 as I told you, but and that is when we developed all the software. But Android 2.2 has a freezing problem. The tablets freeze suddenly in between. So when we complained, we knew that he was working on an advanced device, which is this 1 GHz processor. And he said that is a costly device. But we requested him and he agreed on 14th August. We had a marathon meeting where he agreed to supply us this Android 4.0 version. That is what you are all getting. Now, unfortunately for him, the device which he is working, his specialty, by the way, is capacitive touch screens, which they make in Montreal. I personally visited that factory. They are sending these touch screens to China, where the things are getting assembled with the PCBs, and they use Alwiner A13 processor. That is the processor. That is the reason why the cost is so cheap. Unfortunately, in his design, he had a camera at the top. So he told us when he gave us the samples, that you should pay us more for the camera. The camera cost, after some persuasion, he indicated, was 50 cents. Can you imagine 50 cents a good camera? You can't buy it in the market, but as a small device embedded, it comes in 50 cents. That cost works out to 37 rupees. Now, 37 rupees is not too much money, but because of the need to follow government financial rules, where we have negotiated and given a fixed price contract, I was not sure whether I have authority to increase the price. So when I asked him that we will not be able to pay you this, then he says the camera will not be there in the devices that we will deliver to you. By looking at the way he was telling me, I realized that it's not going to be easy for him to remove the camera. See, those of you who have worked on embedded systems, once a design goes to the manufacturer, you can't change that design halfway through. Of course, he can redesign, and of course, he can instruct the redesign bill of materials to be implemented. I guess that he will not be able to do it before he delivers all 1 lakh tablets. Now, we do not know about that. So, frankly, it is quite possible that the tablets that you receive will not have a camera eventually. As of yesterday midnight report, the first 4,000 lot which has been dispatched has cameras. In all likelihood, the next 4,500 which are coming tonight will have cameras. And hopefully all 20,000 which come in first lot will have cameras. If they all have cameras, I will tell him that now he cannot shortchange the people because the same remote centers will have some cameras and some non-cameras. You have to wish me good luck in further negotiations. I do not know what will happen there. In short, you now have a fairly stable device. These applications are there. While I'll tell you, hundreds of people have worked for the last 4 months here, but this is all just demonstration. These applications are quite thrilling, quite good, and people have taken enormous effort, but this is just a starting point. I would expect students in your colleges, BE students, ME students, teachers, working together on concentrated research projects, should come up with phenomenally large number of applications and contents over the next 2 years. And I am very confident that your people will be able to do that. Just to demonstrate that, by the way, last time when the robo-control was being developed, I had insisted that that work will be done only by summer interns, not by my technical. To prove that students from other colleges are equally capable of doing creative work. It has been proven. It is all up to you now to ask them to do more work.